Hachette Audio presents Girls in Trucks, written and read by Katie Crouch.
A Debutante's Code to Dying. If you are white, are a girl or boy between the ages of 9 and 12, and, according to a certain committee of mothers, are good enough to associate with Charleston's other good girls and boys, then Wednesday night is a busy night for you. Wednesday night from 4 until 7 in the evening is reserved for Cotillion Training School, or, as it is called casually among the students and their families, Dancing School. The number of students is severely limited. Due to demand, children are usually signed up shortly after they are born. The mainstay of the school is the foxtrot, although other, more modern dances are also taught after the classics have been learned. The lindy hop, the cha-cha. The shag is not taught, as, according to Miss Taylor, the school's headmistress, it is common. But naturally, dancing is not all the children learn in Cotillion Training School. At Miss Taylor's school, children are trained how to greet adults properly, how to receive refreshments gracefully, and how not to eat everything on their plate. In a society that is doing its best to leave formality behind, this program works to undo modern attitudes of brashness, to teach children manners, to arm students with the social tools they will need throughout their adult lives. My name is Sarah Walters, and what I knew was the cotillion meant sweat. It meant sticky thighs and saggy stockings. It meant soupy nights in the South Carolina Society Hall, where you were required to 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 hall, Will you require Ivy Hall? 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 Girls, let's talk about boys. I know this is a confusing time for all of you. You may have strange feelings. You may sense funny things happening to your body. We all know, for instance, that Annie is getting a little bigger around the chest already. We can speak privately about that one-on-one. I have a pamphlet. You see, you are blooming, and it makes the boys act silly. They are like bees buzzing around you, and it is your job not to taunt them, girls. Do not taunt the bees, girls. Do not taunt the bees. At cotillion training school, you were not allowed to dance with your cousin. It was a rule. The same way it was a rule that you had to wear gloves and that the boys moved clockwise in the dance circle and that you looked the chaperones in the eye when you told them goodnight. Miss Taylor explained to us that it was unnatural to dance with your cousin or brother or anyone in your family before you were 16. What is she afraid of? Bitsy asked me. I like dancing with my brother. Bitsy's older brother was a star dancer. At her house, they danced all the time. He'd whirl her around, doing advanced steps, even lifting her in the air sometimes and flipping her over his head. He had graduated from cotillion already, but still got paid $10 each Wednesday to assist Miss Taylor with class. She thinks y'all will hump, Charlotte said, in the ladies' lounge. That's perverted, Bitsy said, shuddering slightly. You're perverted. Personally, I liked this rule. I didn't have a brother, but I did have a cousin, and I wouldn't have danced with him anyway, not if you zapped me in a thunderstorm with an electric cattle prod. Ted Wheeler was my mother's first cousin's son. When we were little, we played together. There's a picture of us on the beach, and another one of us naked with a flock of yellow plastic ducks in the tub. Ted was a very good dancer and won the silver dollar for Foxtrotter of the Year 3 times. Bitsy and Annie were a little in awe of him. It was only a dollar, but still, it was a big deal, honor-wise. Do you think Ted would pick me as his partner at cotillion graduation? Bitsy asked one night while we hung out on the stairs, waiting for my mother. I really want a silver dollar. Sure, I said. Bitsy was pretty. She was probably the prettiest girl in dancing school, with silky hair that never got messy, even at a slumber party, and huge blue eyes. Annie and Charlotte were pretty too, but Charlotte was dark and Annie was fat. She already had breasts as big as my mother's, and her arms swelled sweetly against the elastic puff sleeves of her dresses. As for me, I coasted by. I wasn't too fat or too thin. I had braces and freckles and straight brown hair that crackled with electricity in a way that I liked when I brushed it in winter. Still, next to Bitsy, I was nothing. So of course Ted Wheeler would dance with Bitsy. It was sort of silly that she was even asking the question. Not that I approved, though. Ted Wheeler was no one that Bitsy should want to dance with. I knew that she could take care of herself, but Ted was mean. His soul was as black as summer tar. You don't want to dance with Ted, Bitsy, I said. He's evil. Bitsy shrugged. I guess. He seems okay. She was wrong, though. After that tub picture was snapped, Ted Wheeler tried to drown me. Once, I had to get stitches because he hit me on the head with a Tonka truck. Ted's father had left Cousin Cindy for a lady who wore tennis skirts, but it was my opinion that he probably also left because of Ted Wheeler.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.